If you could take your seats, we could get started. Kevin, don't be so serious.
I know. Thank you. Let's go.
All right. Good morning, Blue Hens and friends of the Blue Hens. So that applies to you, Kevin. Thank you all for joining us this morning on this very historic occasion for our athletics program at the University of Delaware and really for the University of Delaware. As you know me now, for 8 years, believe it or not, it's been 8 years since Elaine and I have come to the University of Delaware. I want to thank everybody for your friendship and how you've embraced us all this time. We all shared some dreams, right? I mean, we are committed here at the University of Delaware to the relentless pursuit of excellence, excellence in our academics, in our research, in service, in everything we do, and of course, in athletics, yes? Absolutely. So joining Conference USA and FBS is truly a historic moment for our entire university community, including our alumni and our fans. And this is all of you, right? And I might say for everybody in the state of Delaware, we don't have professional football teams, but we do have the Fighting Blue Hens, right? So a number of notable individuals are with us today, and that's all of you here, including our former chair of the board, John Cochran, who hired me. Thank you, John. Our former professor and trustee, Don Puglisi, and so many other, Don. Several deans and so many other friends, and thank you all for coming and being with us today. But I also want to recognize certainly two people who are standing here at the podium with me. And we have Judy McLeod, who is the commissioner of Conference USA. And Chrissy Raywak, our athletics director. Chrissy was my first hire in May of 2016. We have certainly some things that we shared together from another team that was wearing blue before and similar helmets. I think you make the connection. But more importantly, we all share the exact same dreams with all of you and the same aspirations, right? We all, I'm sure everybody in this room was dreaming one day this university would be playing FBS, right, Fred? That's it. So today, the university is thrilled to be joining Conference USA and stepping out to a more competitive and more prominent level of collegiate athletics. And that means our Fighting Blue Hens football program will compete at the highest tier within NCAA, the Division I football ball subdivision. Yes!
Yes!
This is the moment. Every UD fan knows that our student athletes play with grit, with teamwork and an unstoppable Blue Hen spirit. With this move to Conference USA, sports fans across the country will know it very well, all too well, I think. And we're talking about hundreds of thousands of fans, not tens and 15,000 fans. I mean, lots of them, right? Over the past several years, UD and its generous donors, with the strong support of our trustees, have made significant investments in our athletics program. This beautiful facility, the Whitney Athletic Center, is one of the most visible examples, as are the improvements we've made to Delaware Stadium. And I'm sure there'll be many more along the way. Most importantly, these facilities represent investments in our student athletes and our fans, who deserve the best athletic experience we can provide. The evolution of our athletics program is in tandem with the strong upward trajectory and momentum of the entire University of Delaware. I said before, I had some dreams when I came 8 years ago. We've realized one of my three dreams. The second one is to build 5 million square feet of space on Star Campus. We have about 1.5 million, so 3.5 more million square feet to go. So that's quite a bit. Well, I hope the third one would be something that all of us will need one day. That's a medical school here at the University of Delaware in the state. So our rigorous academic programs are ranked among the best in the nation, and our graduates go on to become leaders, entrepreneurs, scientists and engineers, teachers, artists, and more. UD alumni, more than 200,000 around the world, including about 50,000 who are living right here in Delaware, are making vital contributions to our communities every single day. And our innovative education research that happens at UD lead to ideas and inventions that help people live longer, healthier lives, that grow and strengthen the economy, and that build bridges across diverse cultures and perspectives. The positive and enduring impact of the University of Delaware reaches far and wide. And this move to Conference USA, Judy, is one more step in raising the national awareness of that impact and the visibility of our students, our faculty, our staff, our alumni, our supporters who made it possible. And if just a little lick created 2 million impressions on social media, imagine what will happen when we win championships and play balls, right? That'd be amazing. We'll see all of you in the Bahamas in a couple of years. Couple of years, give us 2 years. So we are thrilled for our student athletes, our fans, and the entire university, and we're eager to begin competing in Conference USA. So now, without any further ado, I'd like to introduce the leader of Conference USA for the past 8 years, someone who has been a successful leader and guided the league through the latest wave of realignment, an exciting new television contract, and now the addition of the University of Delaware in Conference USA. Judy McLeod.
Thank you, President Asanas, and thanks everybody for having me today. The commissioner rarely gets clapped for, so thanks for that too. But this is an incredible week for both Conference USA and the University of Delaware, and you know, of course, when we were planning this announcement, we thought, well, you know, the football team will have just won in the first round of the playoffs. The volleyball team's on their way to Nebraska for the NCAA tournament. Conference USA has an incredible matchup Friday night, undefeated Liberty hosting New Mexico State, who's 10-3 and on an 8-game winning streak. Most notably, they captured a big win at Auburn recently. So that game's on CBS Sports Network, 7 o'clock Friday. So that's my last plug. Sorry. And volleyball for us, number 21, Western Kentucky, heads into the NCAA tournament as well, and they go to Tennessee. So a lot going on, the perfect time to make this announcement, and we couldn't be more excited to welcome Delaware as our 11th member. Throughout, you know, the crazy environment of conference realignment, which I guess is just part of a commissioner's job description now, you know, we get asked frequently, oh, how do you go about this? How do you decide which schools? And I have to give a lot of credit to our presidents, our board of directors, who've been very thoughtful and very thorough in this process. And we have a pretty exhaustive list of criteria. And I will tell you, the University of Delaware checks every box. You know, it starts with, and I know President Asanas mentioned all of the achievements, but it starts with the flagship university that's an R1 institution, so well recognized academically. And then that academics bleeds over into athletics, where the student athletes have great GPAs, the APR, everything is really good, graduation rates. So that's important to us as we look for our partners. Then, you know, the competitive achievements and the rich history really speak for themselves. The facilities here, you know, it's a visible sign of the commitment that they have, that I guess I'm going to say we have. Can I say we now? The budget's right in line with our schools, the media market, fan engagement, and just the excitement for the Blue Hens around the region was really impressive to us. And so really, Delaware brings a comprehensive package that the key to, I think, in talking with Chrissy over this last, I don't know, couple months maybe? Went pretty fast, but it was frequent conversations. It's really encouraging how they support, how you support your student athletes. And that the student athlete experience, I know people talk about it, and sometimes it's just kind of something to say. But here, their experience really matters. And that means a lot to us because that's how we feel as well. So if you combine all of those things, along with, I think, the alignment with athletics in the university mission, the leadership and quality of these two here, and their alignment is really important. And maybe one of the most important things is the high level of preparation and readiness that this school has to make this step. And so it became very clear that the University of Delaware is right for Conference USA, and we're thrilled to be here today. You know, there are many challenges in college athletics, and I think, you know, we're just excited to bring in another partner that's going to face those and attack the opportunities that we have in front of us. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to a woman that probably doesn't need an introduction in this room, but I would like to say that what Chrissy and her team have done over the last 7 years to grow this program and get it ready for this step is extremely impressive. She is nationally respected as an administrator, and we can't wait to get her in our AD room and to get to work. So, ladies and gentlemen, your athletics director, Chrissy Raybock.
Take a deep breath. Thank you, Judy. Incredibly grateful. I want to thank all of you for being here. What an incredibly exciting day, celebrating the University of Delaware joining Conference USA. As you can all imagine, this does not just happen. So I appreciate you bearing with me as I have a few thank yous I need to make. First and foremost, I want to thank President Asanas for his vision and leadership, to our Board of Trustees for their continued commitment to excellence and ensuring, and I mean that ensuring, that this was the right decision and the right time for our university. Thank you to Commissioner Judy McLeod, and she referenced this, patience, leadership, and support through this process. I did call a lot, had a lot of questions. I am grateful to the incredible group of people I get to work with every day. Angie, Karen, Jordan, Chelsea, Dan, James, Kia, Andrea, Jack, Jake, Susie, Nick, and Ed. My university colleagues, Mary Remler, Mandy Minner, Jim Dicker, John Long, Rhett Ruggiero, Carlos Asarta, our faculty athletic rep, and the entire faculty athletic board, our head coaches, and finally, last but certainly not least, our OCM colleagues. Thank you for your commitment to excellence. We spent a substantial amount of time evaluating this move to a conference that sponsored FBS football. Along with our team, we partnered with well-respected consultants in the college athletics world for feasibility studies, financial and economic impact studies, Title IX gender equity studies, and more. This group's collective expertise and wisdom made it clear that this was the right decision at the right time for our university. The successes of our programs on and off the field of competition is a testament to our coaches and student athletes who work incredibly hard every day to exemplify our core values and expectations of working to become the best versions of themselves, which ultimately leads to competing for championships. Over the last 7+ years, we've experienced wins in athletic competition, in the classroom, and in the community. We have had a collective 3.0 GPA for our student athletes every single one of those years, including this last semester, a 3.3 GPA, our highest ever. We have won a combined 25 conference championships, 27 individual NCAA appearances, 13 NCAA postseason wins, and one national championship. We finished 114th out of 362 Division I institutions in the Learfield Directors Cup, an increase of 146 spots since 2015-2016. 146. Clearly demonstrating the growth and momentum of our department. And we are incredibly excited to combine this growth as a proud member of Conference USA. Both President Asanas and I have had the opportunity to get to know Commissioner McLeod, as well as the presidents and the athletic directors from Conference USA member institutions. And it was evident, incredibly evident, that our values and aspirations are aligned. With 3 decades of tradition and success under their belt, new firepower, that would be us, for the future, this is a conference that is embracing the evolution of college athletics, creating formulas that will lead to the next generation of success, providing a platform for us to pursue and attain our next level through commitment, camaraderie, and competition. We get to be a part of that. Who doesn't want to be a part of that? The opportunity to increase visibility for the entire university, competing on national television and on ESPN+, providing opportunities for hundreds of thousands of people to watch our student athletes compete in a sport they love and represent a university proudly. This visibility will not just benefit our student athletes, but will provide a platform and audience for the university to promote all the amazing things happening across this campus and the great state of Delaware. A great example of this visibility, and Judy mentioned this, is going to happen on Friday night. I'm giving us a plug, when Liberty, who is undefeated and ranked in the college football playoff, will host New Mexico State in the Conference USA championship game on CBS Sport Network. I didn't have it, 7 p.m., in case you're wondering. Both teams are in their first season. And just one of 2 FBS championship games on that Friday night. The spotlight will be on those 2 teams across the country. I'm also incredibly excited to share that as a part of this move, we will be adding a women's varsity program. Our commitment to gender equity and providing opportunities for females here to compete at the highest level gives us this moment. And I look forward to sharing the details of what sport it will be and where we will compete next week. And while we are excited to jump right into Conference USA, there is a transition period. Our teams will continue competing in the CAA for the remainder of this year and all of next year. With a change to the CAA bylaws, all our sports, except football, due to NCAA reclassification guidelines, will be able to compete for conference championships and NCAA postseason play throughout. 14 of our teams will join Conference USA as full members. And we have 7 programs that are not currently sponsored by Conference USA, but I can promise you, just as we were relentless in our pursuit of finding an opportunity with Conference USA, we will be relentless in our pursuit of a conference for each of these 7 programs. We are committed to continuing to provide exceptional student athlete experiences and competing for championships, and that will not change. As this transition period takes place, support from our alums, donors, fans, and community will continue to be critical to our ability to compete at this next level. Maintain championship level resources for our student athletes is imperative. The athletic department will be covering all the operational costs of this transition through fundraising revenue generation, and we are off to a great start with $3.5 million raised towards our $6 million goal this fiscal year. We have always had an incredibly loyal, supportive Blue Hen family, and that support is more important now than ever before. I hope you join our coaches, our staff, our student athletes, and our university in our excitement for this next step as we join Conference USA. The future is certainly incredibly bright for our Blue Hens, and I am so incredibly proud to be a Blue Hen. Thank you, and go Hens.
Thank you, Chrissy. Thank you, all of our speakers. And now, as our program continues, we'll continue with questions from the assembled media. So please raise your hand, and we have representatives with microphones to help with hearing your questions. Please be sure to identify yourself and the outlet that you represent.
Hello, Kevin Tressolini from the News Journal, DelawareOnline.com. Chrissy, I'm sure you get the same emails I get from longtime Delaware fans. Why is being kind of among the elite in the level where you are now in football, why is now going kind of in on the ground floor, I'll use the term ground floor as where you're going, why is that more appealing? Does it come down basically to exposure and economics?
Yeah, it's certainly, I mean, I think giving our student athletes, just like President Asanas mentioned, competing at the highest level. I mean, we want our students at this university to be able to achieve the highest level of excellence in the classroom. It's no different than it is for our student athletes. So it certainly is the right time for us to be doing this. We couldn't be more excited about the opportunity that we have. And I mean, you can't, the reality is visibility is a part of this, right? It's certainly not the only part of the decision. This was incredibly comprehensive, as those who were a part of it know. There were many, many parts of the decision, but the two you mentioned matter. They matter.
Hello, Andy Walter from the Delaware State News. Chrissy, can you talk at all about how you see the football schedule looking in the future? I mean, obviously you can't say who you're playing, but what kind of teams?
So more to come on that. I will tell you that we have had significant interest from a lot of people looking to get us on their schedule. So we're excited about that. But we'll be stay tuned. Stay tuned. Stay tuned.
Scott Klatskin with Blue Hens Radio. This is a big news for all of us, and certainly the student athletes found out, I'm sure, this week. How did they find out, and can you describe kind of the reaction of the student athletes?
Well, I think many of them probably found out from Pete Thamel, who as President Asanas,
the leak,
the two million views, excuse me. But certainly yesterday, actually, we brought everybody together to share this news, and they're certainly excited. I think that, you know, you don't necessarily always know exactly what does that mean, but I know that they recognize and understand the opportunity that they have now to compete at a higher level. And what that does for them, obviously, as student athletes, and for our programs, and again for our university, that they are so incredibly proud to represent.
And if I could add something, you know, our students are incredibly bright and smart and career-minded and oriented, and they know that some of them will become professional athletes, but not everyone, but everyone will become a professional at some point in their life. So last night I was interacting with some students in my advisory group as well. And I think they're very, very happy with the additional exposure that the entire university will receive. Imagine those 30-second spots where we could be shining a very bright light on the University of Delaware at the ESPN, ESPN Plus all the time, you know, at so many households. And, you know, these are the prospective employers, the markets, where they want to go, highly populated areas like Texas and Florida, where a lot of people are and where we have not been as present. I mean, we've been much more dominant in the five states surrounding us, including, of course, the University of Delaware, which is a prominent part of the state of Delaware. So I think it's great for everybody. And I have to add the faculty and staff, you know, they've also been overjoyed.
Good morning. Daniel Steenkamer with The Review and WVUD Sports. Chrissy, you mentioned, or it was mentioned on stage, in the last couple months, 2 months or so, this picked up, and you were calling Commissioner McLeod and doing all those necessary calls. You know, timeline-wise, was there a shift where this became, because there were a number of conferences at the FBS level that had been speculated about, and so was there a shift that kind of, in the last couple months or so, that pushed it this direction?
Yeah, I think if you look in the last 2 years, right, the college athletic landscape shift, which I think now we might be 65 teams that have changed conferences. So, you know, in that moment, President Asanas and I, probably about a year ago, said, okay, it's my responsibility to study this. What makes the most sense for us? And it took that long because, again, as I described, it was very comprehensive. This is not a singular decision. There's a lot of things that we need to consider in these decisions. So it came down again about a couple months ago that we realized, you know what, let's really explore this. The data demonstrates that this is the right decision for us to consider, but let's explore it. Let's take it to that next step and really take a look at what opportunities are out there, because we certainly wanted the right one. And again, we're incredibly grateful and lucky that the right one happens to be with Conference USA.
And I have to say that student newspaper, The Review, that you work for, got it right. You know, you guys had an editorial
about a year ago in January.
I said, like, why are the administrators not doing this? You know, and gave us. And I said, like, are you part of our boardroom?
Got one in the back.
Sean Green with WDEL. You mentioned that the operation is not being covered by the university, but how will the average student that maybe isn't interested in sports, or they're going to have to pay more as a result of this move and obviously the higher costs of the travel and everything that comes with going to a national league?
Yeah, I appreciate the question. No, the answer is no. And a part of that is because when you transition to an FBS league and Conference USA, there is revenue generating opportunities that come directly from the league itself, as well as other types of revenue generating opportunities that we'll have. So all of the expenses are going to be covered by those.
And
university
I have to,
is not going
to
be...
I have to categorically state that our average student will not pay more. You know, that was one of the conditions I laid upon our study, you know, when we started it out, that this needs to be neutral. And in fact, over time, perhaps reduce the dependence of athletics on the university budget. And I think we do have that opportunity, as Chris was saying, with the media contract, with other opportunities. But the most important opportunity is the ability of our athletic programs to draw back to our campus our loyal alumni, friends, and donors. The development opportunities, I think, will increase manifold. And that will only accrue to better academic buildings, better experiences, more endowed professorships, more scholarships, more fellowships for our students.
Hello, Patrick LaPorte with the New York Post. Questions for you, Chrissy. I'm just curious, you mentioned you guys have raised $3.5 million mm-hmm. for that $6 million fee. Was that something you guys kind of wanted to strive for? Through fundraising, as I know, the cost of the reclassification fee went from $5,000 to $5 million.
Yeah. So obviously, as I mentioned, we'd been looking at this for a little while, and the fee got announced in August and voted in October, so that wasn't necessarily part of the plan. But as President Asanas indicated, I knew that if we were going to do this, that we were going to have to make it. We were going to be the ones that had to fundraise. That was the right thing to do. That was the responsible thing to do. And so, you know, when we talk to folks that care about this and believe in this being the right decision, we're very, very fortunate that they opted in and they have been supporting us. And I think the other thing I would say is, you know, this is a long-term decision, right? This isn't about this moment. And I'm not at all going to suggest that $5 million isn't a lot of money. It is a lot of money. But at the end of the day, to make a decision based on that is going to have the kind of impact that we've just described in this moment, I don't think serves our university well and the people that really believe and care about what we're trying to do here across the board, not just in athletics.
If you paid attention, under your seat there's an envelope, so just make sure.
It all counts, too, just so you know. It all counts.
Connor Metz, The Review. Chrissy, can I just ask you how much of this process involved looking at other schools that have kind of made the FCS to mm-hmm. FBS jump, especially yeah. those in the same conference? I mean, How much did you look at how they did it, their successes, you know, academically, athletically? How much of the part of the process was that?
Brilliant question, Connor, and the answer is a ton. You know, at the end of the day, we wanted to be sure we understood the likelihood of success. Because there are schools that have done this well, and there are some schools that haven't. And so what can we learn from those? And I can tell you with great certainty, which made this decision even that much more clear, is our history of success. I mean, so much of this, while I spoke about the 7 years of success we've had, comes from the history of the success of our programs, particularly football. I mean, we are standing, you've heard me say this, we're standing on those shoulders. And so the history of success, the fan engagement, the recruiting footprint, we live in an area that has a lot of talent in football recruiting and others, as you can imagine. And so those were some of the things, our facilities, the campus, the fact that we have a campus stadium. I mean, those were a lot of the things that we did consider, but that was certainly a component of it, because we're not doing this to lose, just to be really clear. We're coming to win, right? We're coming to win. And so we wanted to be really clear. What was that going to take? What was it going to take?
Jake Owens, Delaware Business Times. Kind of a two-part question, but similar in nature. You mentioned in yesterday's release that you guys had completed several studies, including an economic impact study. Mm-hmm. I'm curious if there's anything you could share to that point. And then secondly, you know, media rights are obviously a big part of why schools decide to move from FCS to FBS. Conference USA obviously is a much more lucrative media contract than the current CAA. I'm curious if you felt that with the recent success of Delaware programs, football, basketball, volleyball, lacrosse, was UD being undervalued by its current contract with CAA in terms of what you felt was inappropriate?
Yeah, and we do have data, and happy to share that. The economic impact study was obviously very helpful for us, and we do believe that based on the study, and it was done by ESI, who did the university one, that this is going to create an opportunity for our entire state as people are going to come in and stay in hotels and enjoy Main Street and, you know, all of those things, which is obviously a significant opportunity for the state of Delaware in this region. You know, I think when you're looking at media deals, it's not just one school, right? It's the combination of all of them. And this woman is probably better suited to answer this question. So feel free to comment or correct me. And so we're one of many, obviously. And I think that when you look at the CAA, it's not comparable. It's just not. And that's not to say Conference USA is better than CAA or CAA is better than Conference USA. I mean, it's just not in the same arena. And so, you know, I think that's, again, a part of this decision for us was this is the arena we belong in. This is the arena we want to be in. And the opportunities for us are endless. I mean, limitless. And, you know, it's kind of cool that that's what the tagline of this conference is. And we've talked about that. It's like, I don't want to limit us. Why am I going to do that? President doesn't limit us. I'm not going to either. You want to comment on any of that?
This is the best Q&A I've ever been a part of. You two are nailing it, so I'm good.
So, you know, the only thing I would add is, you know, I know many of you have traveled at different parts of your lives to places like the Nittany Lions and, you know, the Wolverines and all those places in the country. And, you know, when there's a football weekend, the economic development impact is in the multiples of millions. And I'm not saying we have a stadium of 100,000 seats, at least not yet. But, you know, it does bring a lot of economic development. I think the hotels, the restaurants, the airlines, the buses, everything. The other thing that I want to mention, which is really not quantifiable in any immediate way, but it's certainly important if you're a long-term player, is our university has been blessed year after year. We're getting 10 and 20% increase in the volume of applications that are coming in. You know, last year we had 37,000 applications for a class of 4,200. This year, I think, Rodney, we're going to get to 40,000. Right? But next year, Rodney promised me with Conference USA, it will be more than 50,000. I mean, I'm just saying. And you know, with all that, you can understand because, as I was saying, we're currently getting dominantly applications from the five Northeast states and a few others from everywhere else. But imagine when we are opening up ourselves to the Texas market, the Florida market, people will understand what a gem the University of Delaware is. And it's going to get harder and harder, folks, to get in here. I think some of you in the room would not have been able to be admitted, you know, in a few years. I see a lot of smiles. But this is exactly what it is, to be excellent in your academics and excellent in your athletics. They go together.
Hey, Chrissy, the last time you guys were willing to submit data to Knight Newhouse, it said that your athletic budget was $48 million. Mm-hmm. How much bigger? Is that going to have to get bigger now? And if so, how and how much and how do you do it?
Yeah, absolutely. And it will a bit. I mean, as Judy mentioned, we are competitive in the Conference USA budget already, you know, how we invest. But the revenues that I mentioned that are coming from this are what's going to cover the expenses. So the adding of the women's sport, some of the additions from a staffing perspective that will likely need to happen. But that was all part of the comprehensive study, and the experts that provided us that data really, again, made it clear that we are positioned incredibly well. There's not a lot of significant investment that we made. And the other thing on the travel component, you know, because we live where we are, the Philadelphia airport, the Baltimore airport, that is making it actually much more affordable than others may realize. That access is significant. And so it'll obviously be a little bit more, but the revenue generating opportunities we have that are coming in from joining Conference USA is what's covering it.
Do you have a ballpark figure of what you think it might have to be? I mean, 50 million, 55, 60? I mean,
a little bit, probably about 50.
Okay,
yeah, yeah.
Gotcha.
Again, not significantly more, but it's going to be covered by the revenue generations.
In the 10% range over what we have now.
Okay. You know. While I have the microphone in my hand,
you can ask others questions Tress. You know,
Chrissy. So when the football scholarship limit goes up from 63 to 85, mm-hmm. will Delaware be able to be above 63 next fall?
Yes.
And if that is the case, why would CAA teams want to play you?
So we are. You are able to do that. And it is actually the reason that there's a couple components of that question. We have agreed with the CAA that we will not be playing more than 63.5 scholarship student athletes when we play CAA teams, so that there is that opportunity to be fair. I think Jordan negotiated that, right, Jordan? Yeah. So... You know, that's the world that we're going to live in. And again, as you mentioned, or as was mentioned, we, based on that, that's why NCAA does not allow you to compete for championships.
But how do you do that? How do you say, oh, today we're only going to make 63 guys available instead of 85? I mean, how does that work?
That's for Ryan to figure out. You can ask that question to Coach Cardi. Is he in the room? I think he's in the room somewhere. Yeah, there he is. He's waving. He's about to run, just so everybody knows. He's out of here. Sorry, Coach.
We have time for a few more.
Commissioner McLeod.
Thank you.
It's time. It's time.
I thought I was going to make it all the way through.
Commissioner McLeod, you know, it's a bit of a two-part question. So to begin with, you know, were you able to make a campus visit here as you were vetting the University of Delaware? And if so, if you could share, when was that? And what were your impressions and takeaways if you did?
Yeah, we made a secret visit.
It was secret.
It was secret. Our board chair and one of our other presidents came with me a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. All this, you know, through realignment, I can't even tell you when or what year or what day it is, but we were extremely impressed. You know, we'd seen everything. All of the photos of the facilities, everything. But when you get here and see it live, it makes a really good impression. So this building right here, unbelievable. So we had a great visit, and our board had, I don't know if I should, I've already started, so I guess I'll share this. Our board had given us approval contingent on the visit. And so at lunch,
yeah,
at the president's house, we were able to...
Actually, president's in Eleni's house.
Yes. We were able to make the offer, and a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah. We did it so well that even Kevin did not figure it out. Right? It was on a Sunday. We can do good things if we want to.
Well, and then speaking of traveling and the geography, you know, and the Northeast kind of the label and title, I know there's been a narrative about FBS football in the Northeast and that kind of thing, and a lot of speculation. You know, what are the benefits? What is the upside to Conference USA getting its reach into this kind of mid-Atlantic and sort of Northeast part of the country? And then I have to ask, Nibdi, is there another shoe to drop that you can talk about today?
Mm. Well, I think we're targeting 17 members. That was a joke. Anybody? don't put that out on Twitter or something. But for us, growing in this region when we have Liberty, you know, it became a really natural process. But it really opened up a lot of the media markets and the fan bases that, you know, probably haven't followed Conference USA. And so for us, it was a natural fit for our growth. Geography is hard. It's really hard. So I can't say we have the magic answer. But because it seems like over the past few years, we've had a different number of members through all the transition, our staff is really adept at scheduling and trying to minimize if we're going to send Delaware to New Mexico State, they're also going to play UTEP on the same trip, things like that. So, our staff would really like us to get to a number and stay so they don't have to create new scheduling models every year. But since they're so good at it, we're going to keep working. We have not set out and said I was quoted last July, you know, well, maybe 12 is a good number, so now everybody thinks 12. So that's a mistake on my part. I never should have said a number. So we can throw the 17 number around. But our presidents have been really intentional and thoughtful through this process. And so if we find another institution that fits all the criteria we're looking for, we're open to that. You know, is that going to happen tomorrow or this calendar year? I would say no, doubtful. So we'll keep you guessing a little bit, but it's an ongoing process. It's part of every board meeting we talk about membership. We actually have a membership subcommittee that has four presidents and one of our athletic directors. And so it's just part of the world now. And so we want to be prepared, but obviously if we can find another fit that's fantastic and adds a lot, then we'll certainly consider that.
And we told Commissioner McLeod and President Caboni from the beginning that Chrissy and I would be more than happy to help recruit the next member. I don't know how many more, but you know, that's up to Commissioner.
Actually, I don't have a vote. It's a membership.
Last one.
Commissioner, you just lost your four best basketball members according to the Sagarin ratings. What did those schools say about why they left, and you know, where do you see this level of athletics going when schools are bouncing around to the Sun Belt and other leagues from this league?
Yeah, I'm trying to think of the four that would have had our best. Actually, when we did analysis of our new membership versus our old, this is before FAU went on the incredible run last year, which was a magical experience for us. The incoming had better ratings as a collective group than the outgoing. So, you know, we're not afraid to try new things and to challenge our members. And so we expect that, you know, it was an AD call early in the year, and we were talking about men's basketball in particular. And somebody said, well, how do you look at the FAU run? Was that just some odd thing that's never going to occur again? I was like, no, guys, that's the standard now. We're stepping up. So we're not afraid of those challenges. We feel like we've added some really quality programs in both men's and women's basketball. And so, you know, conference realignment happens. It's days like this are fantastic. Days where it goes the other way are not as fantastic. But it is part of college athletics right now. And so we're going to challenge our programs to step up. That's what we expect.
Thank you very much. Thank you, President Asanas. Thank you, our athletic director, Chrissy Raywalk. Thank you, Commissioner McLeod, for sharing your insights today around this exciting news. Media members, if you have additional questions for these three leaders or would like to speak with our Blue Hens football coach, Ryan Carty, men's basketball coach, Martin Inglesby, or our faculty athletics representative, Carlos Asarta, please see one of our media relations team members. And lastly, thank you to everyone here and those who joined us via live stream for helping us celebrate a new era for the University of Delaware and Blue Hens Athletics as members of Conference USA. Have a great afternoon, everyone, and go Blue Hens. Yeah.